crap! Holy crap! Oh! He froze me with that punch! Oh my god! Welcome back to the channel. On this episode, it is episode 11 of Undisputed Career Mode Boxing. Let's get right into it. I have a new training manager to get after the last fight. I'm not gonna spoil it. Go back and watch episode 10 to find out where we are right now. But after that last fight, I'm gonna switch this guy to a five-fight contract, and we're gonna look for a new manager. A higher ranked tier, they say. And I'm coming in here, I'm looking at Hank Clark, Quincy Santiago. I might go with Quincy, a brother. That would be so lit. Having a black manager, really understanding what I'm looking for as a black man in the fight game. But then again, some white managers really got some good game. They know a lot of people in the game as well. We got Quincy Santiago, maybe a Brazilian type, and Hank Clark as well. I'm going with Quincy Santiago, the brother. I'm going with Quincy. It feels right. I'm gonna give him a chance, see what he's about, and I'm also gonna get a new cut man because if we remember last time out, we had a horrible injury in the training camp. Hopefully you just came back from the last video so I didn't spoil nothing. That Achilles tear, I'm pretty sure, we could do nothing about it. So, look at that. A recovery, I'm looking at that. I might go with Kat Okoro. Nah, because she's a D ranking. We'll go Jeremy Griffin. No doubt about it. I'm simply looking at the recovery. Oh my goodness, an A recovery, that could be perfect for us. Especially in the fights where we have a big opponent coming up and we just happen to take a minor injury. So, I'll see everybody when it's time to schedule this opponent. And here we are once again for the fight negotiation. We're going to do two media activities. The purse is not that big, but trust me, I'm not looking for monetary gain at this point. I'm looking for legacy gain. Now, this guy right here, I'm pretty sure he is ranked very, very highly on the charts. Maybe within top 20. So if we can get this victory here, I know for a fact it's going to boost our legacy points and our ability to get those championship fights moving forward. All right, though, let's do it. I'm going to Santiago's gym as well. I mean, they treated us very nicely before that championship fight last episode. We're going to do a guest commentary. Lucas Demetriou's going to come in, I guess, and commentate on a Roy Jones Jr. middleweight fight or something like that. So we came in, did that, saw, and conquered it. Now let's go. I'm going to upgrade my counterpunching. I'm also going to do a little bit of yoga. Get back with that health stat. I want to make sure my health just keeps going up. So if I take a few punches to the chin, it's not going to affect me like if I didn't have as much health or cut resistance on the chin. So here we go. We'll do a little bit of offensive sparring as well. We'll do some recovery. Come right back and do the same drill once again. We'll do a little jump rope for some conditioning. We'll do a recovery. We'll go right back at it again for some defensive sparring. And then we'll do recovery one more time. But of course, we are overweight. That's not even overweight. They say it's overweight, but look at that. 155 to 168. I'm coming in at 168. I'm coming in at the top of the weight class, rightfully so. I'm going to have some power in these hands. And I'm coming out here to knock this dude out. I don't know exactly what his background is. I mean, I will go take a quick look at who he is, though. Pedro Cano, a Mexican powerhouse with 11 knockouts, 44 victories, 12 losses, and 3 decision victories. Or 3 draws, that is. 3 decisions. 3 draws. Okay, so his potential is to be one of the best 4-star ring craft, throws short combinations, and he moves in and out. 40 years old, still fighting. Not a quick fighter at all. And this one looks like a fight that we can go out here and starch this guy. Minimum fame, talking about 6,000 he needs. I'm not too sure exactly what that is, but if somebody can let me know the requirements right here in this section, what this means, I would greatly appreciate it. We can see his rankings as well down there in the bottom left. 22, 21, 21, and 24. Now, that's a big jump up from my ranking, which is about 30 right now on average. About 30. So he's about ranked 20, 22, and I'm ranked 30. So hopefully with this fight and this victory, we'll go out here and get the top 25 ranked in the world. Now, Lucas Demetriou is a champion. There's no doubt about that. Win, lose, or draw this fight, we know he'll still be a champion. But I'm pretty sure his belt is on the line this fight. Every time he goes out there, we know what to expect. We're looking for a great performance and a great knockout. If I can get a couple knockdowns and build those up, I think we'll go out here and get this victory today. But here we go, Lucas Dimitri, 2 losses, 19 wins with 8 KOs versus Pedro Cano. I'm ready. And look at him, Lucas Dimitri, feeling great. Really? They're talking about a close, controversial win. Those that watched that last fight know that was not close at all, and that was definitely an ass whooping. But here we go. Look at that man, feeling good and feeling great. But look at Pedro Cano. His last fight was a knockout as well. He got knocked out. So hopefully if I come out here and get the knockout, I'll just keep moving forward. And I'm still looking for Patrick Recall. Best believe me. Those that watched that fight, both of them, know exactly what is at stake against Patrick. And I'm looking for a victory here today. Oh my goodness. Good power in those hands. That's the main goal today, is do not get touched by those hands. He's going to be moving in and out. And he's 40 years old. So he's got experience in the game for sure. But Lucas Dimitri is not worried about any experience. He's not afraid of any man. He's going to eventually get up to heavyweight for sure. And hopefully when that time comes, he'll be ready. Let's go.
Nice counter punch right up the middle.
Good combination. Left hook, right hook as well. His guard is not great. So if I can just stay up on my pivot, keep moving, don't let him touch me, and touch him up, it'll be a victory. That's for sure. Switch stance. Looking for that left hand. That left straight is cash. If I land it, it could be a night-night opportunity for us. And we're looking for it right now. Good left hand as well. And that combination off, we always want to be touching up that chin. And that's what we're looking to do. 5-6 punch combination, all hitting his block or his face. I'm not even sure on that one, but we're definitely beating up the block today. Oh my goodness, man. We're looking for a KO. Hey, good little push back from Cano. And we're moving now. A little bit of frame rate skip, but not to worry. Lucas Dimitri right now is looking like a beast. And look at his guard. His guard looking a bit different, and I like it. Upgrading that guard, of course, and a beautiful five-punch combination. I mean, we're just looking for the punches that are going to do the job. If I had to throw 3 hooks in a row, don't get mad at me. I'm just working on what works, you know? 92% stamina and 80% health right now. Not really what I expected, but I know I'm doing damage if he is on me, for sure. Oh, wow, good slip. Let's go, let's go. Beautiful combination, trying to land it, but he keeps moving that head. He's a good fighter, Pedro Cano. I mean, I can't be tough on him and think he's trash because I know he's not. Beautiful clinch, though. I mean, of course he wants to clinch me up. I'm doing the jab, lead hook, rear uppercut. Then I go to the body uppercut. This dude does not know what's hitting him right now. And we're looking for a KO today. Yep, for sure. I mean, I'm definitely not looking forward to this clinch that he keeps wanting to throw in there. It seems like all my opponents go for the clinch. Let me know what you guys think of that, though, down below. Do you guys, when you guys play face with the clinch a lot? I haven't been watching other people's videos, so I don't really know exactly how this game plays. Maybe it's just the middleweight class. They love clinching up. And look at this. Is that even a logical clinch? You know, like, where do we draw the line? Ref, can we step in here? Come on. Come on. Yeah, we feeling good. Whoa! Did not want to do that. Got a little bit of blood on his glove now on the left side of my face. It's a left-hand cut. Triple jab and a hook. Oh, my goodness. We're throwing punches now. All right, it's time. It's time. Let's go. Let's lock in. Oh!
How about
Holy crap! Holy crap! Oh! He froze me with that punch! Oh my god! Oh my gosh! He floored me with that right hook! What? Beautiful punch. That's all I gotta say is a beautiful punch. Wow, okay. So he's got round two. What a heavy knockdown. And I'm not going towards that hook at all right? Keep rotating. Let's actually go for the southpaw. Or the orthodox, excuse me. Keep rotating. Make sure we do not get touched. Because he put us down with that left hook. Beautiful left hand from Lucas. Uh-oh, guard up. Yeah, I gotta be very careful. He has a lot of power in those hands. He kind of reminds me of Canelo Alvarez. I mean, he doesn't really fight like him, like the body punches and whatnot, but he definitely has the power like Canelo for sure. Beautiful. I'm not sure what this announcer is talking about. I don't know who caught who, but I know I'm landing a lot of punches right now, so maybe he's talking about Lucas Dimitri. There it is, three punch. Looking for a combination, but no luck. I'm going high, low, body to the face. Good uppercut. There we go. That body uppercut right now is doing a lot of damage. Ah, good straight. It is all offense right now. And I'm looking to slip these punches coming in. Beautiful. Let's go. Coming right back with my own. Little 1-2 to the body. I like it. Jab straight to the body. Left hook up top. Get out. If we can't land that left hook, we know it ain't going to be a continuous combination. Let's go. I'm looking for that rear uppercut. I don't know how to throw it in an orthodox. It's a little unorthodox. A little bit of a tongue twister there. It's unorthodox to throw the orthodox rear uppercut. But I think you have to kind of like swoop your stick off bottom right maybe. Or it could be bottom left. Let's see. Guard up. Oh my goodness. Yeah, this fight right now is definitely a fight for the history of the books. All right, going into the fourth round. This fight is a fight for the history books for sure. Me and him are going back and forth. I'm bleeding, he's not. But I need to get a cut on that eye. Keep doing what you've just been doing because you've won that hands down. I wish it was like UFC 5 a little bit. Like if I got a cut above my eye and now I can't see, like maybe my defense goes down. I'm not sure if that's how it works, but if it does work like that, then that's amazing. That's realistic because you know what I'm saying? Like you can't really see out that eye. Now you got one eye closed up.
Got him there.
You're fighting with just the left. You are not going to see those punches coming in from your right side.
So he's going to shake.
He's moving in and out for sure. That's his style. Nice. Beautiful combination, right though. Looking for the jab right hand. And he's pushing back. He does not want me pressing up on him right now. And I'm ready. Come on. Good jab. Step back.
He's dropped the guard.
He's that
now.
Jab.
What do you think of that decision?
If he comes in, I'm just going to pop him with that jab every time. And he's trying to hit me with that left hook as well. We'll see if we duck a little bit. There we go. Beautiful. Trying to come back with my own punch, but just completely missing it. We're back and forth right now, rotating to my right. Trying to make it out, and I do. Trying to go with the uppercut, and a beautiful combination. I turned his neck around. Oh my goodness, he is getting through that guard. Trying to slip that punch, but no luck. I'm trying to go Matrix. There we go. Just what I'm looking for. Beautiful one again. It's beautiful right now. The counter-punching style from Lucas Dimitri is in full effect. Step back. Body punch.
Try and relax a little bit now.
Slip back. I'm ready. Good combination. Left hook, right hook to the face. No idea what's going to hit him. A beautiful left hand as well. Stepping back now.
Catch and shoot.
Combination to end the round. Come on. Finish strong. There we go. Left hook, right hook, lead uppercut to the body. Going with a hook to the body as well. I like how they say, we're going to get that round to you know who. I have no idea who they're giving it to. But I think it's me. They're saying it's one-sided, so they must be giving this round to him. The last one. He did drop me. So I'm thinking, I feel like I had this one, you know what I'm saying, in the bag, but you never really know with these judges. I've seen IRL judges make crazy decisions. UFC judges. I think one of the UFC Mexico judges had Yair Rodriguez winning 4-1. Or excuse me, not Yair Rodriguez, Brennan Moreno against Brendan Royval. They had him winning 4-1. Yeah. I like Brennan Moreno a lot at 125, but everybody knows that was either a 4-1 for Royval or a 3-2 for Royval. No way it was a 4-1. But we're just backing up now while I'm talking a little bit. Beautiful combination. Let's go. Keep moving. Let's go. Lucas Demetri is ready. He's got blood on his face, and in the fifth round, he's looking for the knockdown. Good slip. Looking for the combinations now, but no luck. Stepping back off that center line, looking for the body hook, and we're keeping moving. Keep it moving.
That jab doesn't find a home.
Let's go. Rotating now, looking for the victory. And he's landing some good nice punches, throwing some good combinations, but they're not all landing on me. And of course, a clinch, but this doesn't even make sense. Look at this clinch.
There's a tactic to clinching.
When you can clinch, we take a point already? Like, how many clinches do they have until a point is taken? Three, four, five? There we go. This is me. This round is all mine. And a good straight almost clips him on the jaw, but no luck. Let's go! Yes! Yes! Knockdown in the sixth round for Lucas Demetri, and I think this fight is over. Oh! Where did it come from? Nobody has any idea. And a beautiful right hand clips him, and then the left as well. Drops him down to his back, and now he's looking at the mat differently. Let's see it again. A good jab in the left hand. Clips him up. Let's see from this angle though. Beautiful jab, beautiful left hook, beautiful right hand. And then the left hand comes in again and drops him clean to the floor. And Lucas the Myth Demetri is now building up that legacy to become the legend, Demetri. I like it, Luke the legend. 7, 8, and he's up to his feet at the count of 8. It's tough to get up off that ground, I'll tell you what.
Well, he's back,
but it seems like they always do for some reason. Move in, move in, move in.
And the referee will begin the count. 10
and he's done. And he's done. Oh my goodness. He is out. There's no way he's up. There's no way he's getting up. Look how he got put down.
I need to see that again.
Look how he got put down, man. He's got the back on the ropes. Doesn't know what to expect. He's not getting up. Eyes rolled back. He's got the whites of his eyes looking like the Undertaker right now in his ring. A beautiful showing from Lucas Demetri right now. And I mean, who's going to beat this man? Who's going to beat this man? Nobody is the answer. He's definitely getting to that point where he's knocking out anybody he sees. And a great victory once again for Lucas the Myth Demetri. Beautiful. It didn't look good for him in that second round. Got caught with the left hand. But I mean, we came out there with those hooks. Left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right. Coming out there, and we threw 121 hooks. That's crazy. That is crazy. Not very often you see somebody throw more hooks than they do jabs. But I mean, if we're throwing that jab, coming in with that left, coming in with that right, that makes 2 hooks to 1 jab. So I mean, I can definitely see how we had more hooks than jabs. And I mean, we got the knockout, so I'm not complaining. However, we have to go out here and get this knockout. If it isn't cheating, I'm with it. If we go out here, throw body punches, just ruin a guy, I mean, it might as well be the same thing. Throwing hooks in the face and throwing body hooks. I might have to come out there next fight and showcase my talents even brighter. But here we go, the earnings. $6,300 and 1,132 fame. Wow. 17 staff XP. WBC, I'm up 2. IBF, up 3. WBO, up 2 as well. And the SCI, I'm up 2. I think I might have to defend my belt this next fight. I'm going to see, though. I might try and get another belt as well. I'm going to see the rankings, but let me cover the fight rating. Opponent rank, an A. B, offense. B, defense. A, accuracy. C, damage management with an A result. 12, coach affinity as well. and we're looking great. Enter a fight with 100 energy and fight sharpness, boom. Win a fight by KO, boom. Next fight, I should get that tier 2. Finish a fight without suffering any swelling. Maybe block power punches to the head. And, ooh, wow, win a fight after getting knocked down. I've won 5 fights after being knocked down. Historic man, Lucas Dimitri is. Let's lose a little bit of weight, and I'll see everybody when it's time to schedule this next fight. It's that time once again to schedule a fight, and I like the manual opponent selection. It allows me to have more control over who I can fight and who I will be fighting. Look at it, Sean Porter. What? Yo, I might fight Sean Porter. I'm fighting Sean Porter, bro. I don't care. Let's go. Sean Porter versus Lucas the Myth Dimitri. Come on, man. We're going to go to Magna. We're going to go to Magna Fighting Facility. I'm not sure where that is. I'm going to put down the fight promotion to maybe 8%. 3 media activities. And let's get to it. Sean Porter versus Lucas the Myth Dimitri. A fight for the legacy. A great fighter. Look at that record. 38, 16, 2, and 16. What? This man has put in work in the boxing ring. Sean Porter is a historic fighter, and this is definitely a fight for Lucas Dimitri's legacy. It's that time, though, to go and pick the training camp. And look at that. Finally, we are at a new training camp, and we cannot overtrain here. Okay, not bad. I mean, we're going to try it out, though, right? I mean, we've tried all the other gyms, so let's give a new look and a new feel to this new area. I feel like this one might be in Miami, though. That's what it kind of feels like to me. It's a B gym, so hopefully we're not getting hurt at all. That's what all I'm wishing for is do not get hurt. We'll do a couple media trainings. Matter of fact, we'll do all 3 right now. Get them out the way and get ready to start training. All right, let's go. I'm feeling good, but I'm going to get that counter punching up. We're at 80 right about now. Maybe if I can get it to 85 before this next fight, I highly doubt I'm going to do that, but definitely not going to get it to 85. So let me pivot a little bit and make sure that I'm covering all my stats going into this next one. Stamina regeneration for sure. And a right arm strain. Oh my gosh. It's going to cost us 12 bands, and that's no issue whatsoever. Our physio definitely has the ability to get us right back on track, and that's exactly what we decided to do. All right, so I think if we do 2 recoveries, we're good to go. It's that time, Sean Porter versus Lucas the Myth Dimitri. A fight for the future, a fight for the history books for sure, and we're gonna see right now what Sean Porter still has in the tank. 100% charged up, 95% fight ready, and 166 pounds on the dot. We're feeling good, and I'm feeling awesome for this fight. I want to make sure we check out Sean Porter's abilities, though, so we're not taken off guard. Look at that. From the same area as well, Las Vegas, Nevada. I wish we could fight at the MGM, and I'd have this fight there for sure. This was battle for the sin right here. Look at that. Body health. He's pretty good there. Power punching, decent speed, and a good chin resistance. I mean, he's a good fighter, and he just came off a TKO as well. Kano knocked this dude out. This is the dude we fought. We knocked out Kano. Wow. So, okay. So if Kano beat this dude and he didn't beat Kano, we should come out here and beat Sean Porter. I'll see everybody when it's time, though, to go out here and punch this dude in the mouth. Can't use that audio, so I had to do it myself. It is that time, Magna Arena. Lucas the Myth Dimitri versus Sean Porter. I'm not sure what his nickname is, but I know what time it is for sure. Lucas the Myth Dimitri is walking out to the ring now with swag and style. Charisma in those hands, and they are definitely ferocious. The mantra tonight is keep your hands to yourself or else you'll feel mine, that's for sure. And here he is, Sean Porter with his own swag, and he's got some drip coming out in some WBC boxing shorts. Beautiful. 16 losses. He's almost got more losses than I got wins. I'm going to let the announcers take over. Let's hear it. Okay, that's not me. That's not me. So, they always just skim over you for some reason. But look at Sean Porter, man. He looked just like him. Ready to go and everything. Gleaming with confidence. And we're going to go out here and get this victory, hopefully. Look at Sean Porter, though, man. He fight. Oh, my gosh. Already. Oh, my gosh. I like this venue a lot. It feels like we're really fighting. Oh. It feels like we're really fighting with fans in the arena. Like 10,000 people here. Hope to sell out crowds like Mayweather eventually. But Sean Porter, oh my gosh, he's getting flustered right now. Rotate.
Touching him up again. The defense failed him.
Oh, already, Sean Porter could go down. Body uppercut. Look for it.
As he weathered the storm. What's the referee think? And there it is.
Hell no, he hasn't weathered a storm. Let's go. Lucas Dimitri is a problem. You do not want to see this man. I'm in my bag right now. Sean Porter got cracked, baby. Look at this. Left hook, right hook, left hook once again. Short one, too. A lot of power in that punch. Definitely didn't see it coming. And that's the way you have to knock Sean Porter. Oh, my gosh. Beautiful left hand. Drops him right to the floor. And Sean Porter is no more. Just like that. Who really knows what Sean Porter has in store in this fight? And I hope he can get up here. I really don't like knocking people out in the first round. I got more respect than that. But I mean, if you get knocked out, that's just on you. You ain't get up, you know? So let's keep moving forward and look for this knockout. They're saying they have to stop this fight. It might be another towel time. Oh my gosh. Them hands right now are too fast. Lucas Dimitri getting loosey-goosey as well. Oh, good slip. Sean Porter is very fast. And I really don't want to get caught with my hands down against a legend like this.
Touching him up again.
I mean, it ain't Muhammad Ali I'm fighting. But he's still got knockout power, and he's still a talented guy. I mean, if I know his name, and I'm not a huge boxing fanatic, that's how you know he's definitely got some clout. And some legacy. Good slip. Beautiful. Nice little three-piece combination. Jab, lead hand, coming in with that rear hook. Beautiful. My coach advice. Great shot to put them down. They felt that, all right. Stay on alert. It's only the first round. That's for sure. Sean Porter's that type of guy. If we allow him to be there, he's going to be there in the fourth, fifth, sixth round. It's 10 rounds, this one. Finally, we're starting to get into those longer fights. So we're going to have to really manage our stamina, or we're going to have to go out for this knockout. There we go. A receipt for sure. He must have bought something at Nike this morning. Here comes the Foot Locker receipt too. Aw. It's always the clinch. That's how you know you're going to win a fight. If they start clinching you up, like look at this clinch. He went for the over under. Looking for the uppercut, but no luck. A wild left hook. Oh my goodness, a beautiful left hand. But he comes back with a great jab on his own right. A good little three-piece combination. Just what we're looking for here. And Lucas Dimitri right now has a heart rate of 120. He's moving for sure. Good left hand. Good straight to the body as well. He's not looking for the body block. Whoa. Nobody dare do anything out of turn. Watch this. Oh, got him a two on the chin. Looking for the jab, backing up now. Moving back in. Let's look for the knockout. Good hook. I like it. Oh, good slip. Definitely not. If you throw a lazy jab, you're going to get knocked out. That's the truth. Because this dude, Sean Porter, is ready to pounce. No drop in this round, but I mean, I'm just doing small amounts of damage. It's going to start picking up this next round for sure. Boom. Five-piece combination, just like that. I'm not playing no games with Porter. And look at that. 100% health. As long as I can keep landing my counter punches, I'll win the fight. He tried coming in with his own hook as well, but I think I landed mine right before he did. A beautiful left hand. I think we're going to have to give this guy a Patrick Ricola treatment. Rotate off to that left. Hit him with the left hand and come back with the right. Beautiful combination. Three piece. Slipping off to the right as well. And a beautiful combination. Let's look for it. Left hand, but a great slip from Patrick. I call him Patrick, like I'm fighting Patrick McCall. I meant Porter. Sean Porter with a great, great chin as well. I mean, he hasn't been able to get knocked down again since that first round. What? No counter punch? I thought I was going to drop him right there, flatline him. Let's go to southpaw now. Look for the jab lead hand. That uppercut is so fast, it's bad news. If he leaves his head open, I'm going to go to southpaw once I rock him. That's what I'm thinking. Boom. Switch southpaw. Come on. I got to go back to orthodox. I'm not that good in the southpaw right now. And look at this. I was about to rock him, and he clinched me up. Look at this, man. This is crazy. Like, where are we? Get to him complaining. Yeah, I'm definitely complaining to the ref in real life. Like, come on, ref. What are we talking about? Sean Porter, though. I'm looking for a knockout. I don't know if this man has the chin to stay with me for 10 rounds. That power's going to be there in the eighth for sure. I don't see it getting that far. We're about to go into the fourth round, and I think it's going to be a knockout within this one or the fifth.
Todd, my motto is, if it's not broken, why change it? An excellent last round, everything.
Oh. Let's look for that lead hook over the shoulder of him. Beautiful. I got to throw that body uppercut to drop them hands and then come up top with a left hook. Let's see if I can work it right here. I'm going to look for a jab, lead hook, body uppercut, left hook. Wow, they say if he loses this fight, it's time to retire. What? I'm about to retire this man, for real. Where's my power at? That's a knockdown for sure. If you're taking that many punches to your face, you need to get some things checked out. Your brain, CTE is a real thing, especially in boxing and football and those sports where you're taking a lot of punches to your face and to your head. Trying to land them hooks, but no luck. Beautiful combination. Let's keep working. Trying to look for that body uppercut, but no luck. Boom. Good combination as well. I'm trying to throw that. There it is. Man, that uppercut can hit him from so far away. Look at that. Oh, and he dropped me in this round. That's what I'm saying. I'm not going to southpaw anymore. I'm throwing, you know, I'm not trying. I'll say that. I'm not really trying. Get up, man. I'm not playing any more games with this man, Porter. It's going to be bad news coming out in this next round. Give him something to live by, though. A nice right hand. Let him know I'm still here. I'm still here, Sean Porter. All right? I don't know what this dude's talking about. I'm going to stay in orthodox now and whoop him. It was an uppercut.
I'd be very, very surprised if he'll come out. Fresh as a daisy. That's not good.
And wisely here, they're going
to
clinch.
Let's go. And look at this man. This man right here is on my nerves. I mean, I'm tapping every button to get about this clinch, and it's just not working. There we go. He's trying to put his body weight on me. It's not going to work.
He threw a punch and just got countered.
I mean, come on, guys. We're landing four-piece combinations. Oh my gosh, Porter. I mean, he got knocked out in his last one, so that's what we're looking for in this. There we go. Beautiful left hand. That left hook is money. If we can keep landing that left hook, we'll probably get this knockout. Boom. Boom. Body uppercut, and I went there again, but I think I might have clipped him on the jaw. Look at that. Beautiful body uppercut. It was sneaky. Oh. Oh, and I clipped him on the way down. Look at that. Beautiful. That's what I'm looking for. Let's see it again. He comes in, working that jab, body uppercut. There it is. And a boom, a mean punch to the face as he's going down. I think Sean Porter is hanging up the boots after this one, hanging the gloves. He's going to hang him on the outside of the rope after this match, put him up in the air like Frankie Edgar, and call it a night. That's what I'm thinking. Done. What? What a beast, man. I got to go out here and knock this dude out.
Well, he's back up, but now what, Johnny?
Somebody can smell blood here. They can smell blood. They've got to be smart. Get in there. Boom.
Well, I can smell blood in the water for sure. Boom. 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 He took a knee. He took a knee. That's the second time we've seen a man take a knee against Lucas the Myth Dimitri. And I'm not sure if he's going to be able to get up at eight. What? That take a knee feature is crazy too. Now, I'm sure that's really a thing in boxing. I've never seen anybody take a knee after, unless it's a body punch. You know, he has to take a knee and take a little breather, so to speak. But the fact that they get up at 8 every single time is ridiculous to me. Because if he gets knocked down, it's over. There we go. It's the 6th round now. And we're just keeping the fight moving forward.
Nice counter shot. Why does he continue to hold?
Wow. Look at this man on the clinch. Get him with a point, please. Go back to Orthodox. Thank you. Step back with that center line. Beautiful. There we go. Oh, my gosh. That power straight was money. There we go. Now let's look for this combination. There we go. Beautiful. I'm looking for the straight to that body. Uppercut up top. Or, I mean, left hook, excuse me. If we can land it, that'd be nice. Oh, but that uppercut he has is sneaky. Lead uppercut. Could be money on us if we allow it to land. Can we please put this man down? If I don't get a knockout victory on Sean Porter, I don't think my career will be the same. Whoa. He's got me cut up. Let's look for some counterpunching. There we go. What do you mean it would be? It is. Done. It's done. That was a long combination right there. Working jabs, breaking a block, and a beautiful, beautiful right hook. I mean, I think we came with the right hook. Look at that. Double jab, lead uppercut to the body, and then doubled up the right hook as well. Sean Porter is over for tonight. I don't think he's getting up. And rightfully so. It's been a long, long night for him. And it's about that time that he retires from the ring. There it is. KO. Beautiful victory. And Sean Porter is flat on his back in the middle of the ring. A little bit of blood on my eye. Hey, and I was talking about, I think last episode maybe, winning fights after being knocked down. 5 of them Lucas Dimitri has won. And now today, it makes 6. A great performance once again from Lucas the Myth Dimitri. And I'll see everybody after this with the fight rewards. And once again, a great performance from Lucas Dimitri. Let's see these traits. Let's see these fight rewards. $29,000, 1,700 fame, 22 staff XP, and we unlocked a new trait as well. I'm pretty sure that's the liver shot, body snatcher ability. And look at that. We are finally ranked top 25. Across the board. So that's definitely the highlight of this episode. Sean Porter knockout. Great performance. And look at that. A opponent rank, B defense, B offense, A accuracy, B damage management with an A result. 12 coach affinity. And that's the way you got to do it out there. A overall. And look at that. Landing counters, landing right hand punches, win a fight after being dazed. No surprise. It's what Lucas Dimitri does. All right, everybody. Just want to say thank you very much for tuning in. If you enjoyed, drop a like down below and subscribe for more content like this. It's been Frank in the Squared Circle with Lucas the Myth Dimitri. Peace out, everybody, and stay safe.